This album, much like Under Stars, actually came together very quickly in a period of about 3.5 to 4 weeks. Freddie at the label emailed me one day and said, you realise the deadline for the release deadline is coming up? And I was like, whoa, I better make the album. No, the truth is that I like to work very quickly. It's something that's always intrinsically part of what I do, you know. Certainly when we made the Frost record, the last Frost record with Jem, I co-wrote quite a few of the songs with Jem on that record, and he was kind of like the idea of having me on board for the very reason that I do tend to like to get a song done a day, or the basic bones of a song done in a day. So very much it was a case of even if the deadline hadn't been looming, I would have probably spent no longer than a month making. I like the energy that you get when you make an album. And I like the idea of, you know, every day just for pretty much an intense focused period of time whereby you kind of, you just heads down, very little sleep, and it's just a sort of, it's just like a force of nature. You don't lose focus at all throughout the entire writing and recording period. So I love the idea that one day you get up in the morning, you haven't got a clue, and then at the end of it, you've got a finished song. And I always write to a title. That really helps the process. I used to find it strange when bands would come in the studio and they'd have strange working titles for songs because they didn't have a final lyric or indeed a final title. And it's kind of like the title is the thing that informs the whole mood of the song and indeed the lyrics. And the lyrics are like some of the first things that I get done, really. I think it's just the whole process a lot quicker. What inspired the album? I don't know. It's a very, very personal album. There's some quite uncomfortable topics towards the end of it, you know, where I deal with things, open up the Pandora's box of my childhood and talk about things that, you know, have affected me and informed my life. And, you know, it also deals, like, you know, with the breakup of a long-term relationship, which is a very sad thing. And, but, you know, it's a very cathartic way of sort of releasing the ghosts, as it were. So those things, both sort of personal matters, I suppose, influence the album greatly. The truth is, I mean, obviously in the wide, wide world of progressive rock, people kind of do tend to like it if you don't go off piste too far, you know, and there is a sense of a lot of bands, not mentioning any names, sort of following a very close format and, you know, kind of not straying too far from the sonic path. And I felt that I'd always set out to do the first three albums as a trilogy, as it were. That's why it's called a trilogy and three albums, I suppose. It's a three album deal. But the main thing is I just felt that I'd taken that as far as it could go, and I really liked the way the sort of arc of it all. I know that they sound quite similar, those three albums, although for some bizarre reason I decided to start playing synth solos on the third one for no particular reason other than it amused me, I think, at the time. But certainly I really like the way that, I think out of the three of them actually, Under Stars is my favourite. And I really like, we made the film, which I really enjoyed the whole cinematic experience and the cinematic sort of nature of it all and the way that it ended, the song and ending. I just felt I'd taken it as far as, and I understand that obviously some people are confused by the fact that it's called Lonely Robot and they thought the whole thing was just a sort of a means to an end to make sci-fi inspired music forever, but actually it was literally, the plan was always just to do three albums in that vein and then sort of move further afield, obviously to compare myself rather pretentiously to somebody far more successful and iconic, David Bowie kind of, I can't believe I'm saying this, David Bowie kind of ran out of steam with Ziggy Stardust at some point, and I felt that the whole sort of, as much as I'm very fond of those three albums, I just felt that I'd taken it as far as I could, and I wanted to sort of start writing music with perhaps more personal nature of the lyrics rather than sort of wistful otherworldliness of the first three albums.